quiz of everything, the supersized mega bucket full English of quizzes. If you haven't seen the show before, like everything big and fat, it's fun and jolly, and no one can quite believe that after all these years it's still going. Okay, let's meet our teams. The perfect way to start the day, it's a little Danish and a cup of steaming Joe. It's Sandi Toksvig and Joe Lycett. He's massive in grime, she's just plain dirty. It looks like something's gone horribly wrong on Match.com. It's Katherine Ryan and Big Narstie. And one is one half of Baddiel and Skinner, and the other is the other half of Baddiel and Skinner. It's David Baddiel and Frank Skinner. See, this show is a bit like being sort of, you know, back at school. What were you like at school, Big Narstie? What were you like?
My teacher said that I had great potential, but I just f***ed up a lot.
They actually said that?
My school doesn't exist anymore. Oh. Closed it.
Did they close it or did someone burn it down? What happened?
No comment.
Katherine, what were you like at school?
Well, I'm not Katherine, for a start, Jimmy. I'm Quiz Jenner. Thank you. You see, Kris Jenner is my woman of the year. I love the Kardashians. They are a matriarchy of shape-shifting sisters who destroy men or turn them to women. It's very much a sci-fi program. I'm into it. I was a very good girl in school, though. Very academic. I just wanted to please adults, and I wanted to do the right thing, and I was not a cool kid. Who'd have known I'd turn into such a slut?
Frank, what was school like in the olden days?
Well, I found as long as you remembered your gas mask, it was okay. I was expelled from school, actually.
Genuinely?
No, genuinely. I was expelled for embezzling the school meal service, was what it said on there.
Did you ask for some more? I think I've seen a documentary about this.
Yeah. Have you met Fagin?
With that,
who had actually, 1 minute?
While we're on the subject, I did go. I went to a Jewish primary school. It was a very Jewish primary school. I had one line in the school play. It was, "Well, Rabbi, you certainly do drive a hard bargain." Now that is very
Jewish. Genuinely true?
Genuinely true. You think it's Rabbi, but then at the end is bargain.
Sandi, were you good at school?
I'm going to top Frank. I got thrown out of 3 schools in a row.
Whoa! No.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, isn't it?
Yeah. Are you genuinely?
Yeah, genuinely, what? Genuinely.
Okay, well, give us the reasons. Give us the.
Well, the last one was a misunderstanding. I had no idea you're supposed to be there every day. And I just found school unbelievably boring. So I went to school in the United States, and I remember the teacher saying, "Oh, this year class, we're going to read Catcher in the Rye." So they gave us Catcher in the Rye. I went home, I read it, I came back in prepared to discuss it. I didn't realise we were going to read it one word at a time all year. So I thought, I'll come back when they've finished. So I got sent to a British boarding school, which is how I ended up here.
I think this is all lies and you were dealing drugs. That's what I... Just be honest about things.
The world's smallest drug dealer.
Yeah.
Joe, at school, tell me, what were you like?
Yeah, I was very sweet. I was very well behaved. I also went to Birmingham, but I went to a grammar school because I'm a prick. And I played by the rules and I got good grades, and here I am, and I'm ready to win.
Okay, on with the quiz. Our first round is all about history, as in historical events, not the thing your dad wipes from the computer every morning. Archaeologists are constantly trying to date things, and maybe if they lost the cardigan and sandals, they'd have more luck. In 1582, Italian scientist Lilius released the Gregorian calendar we still use today. Lilius worked tirelessly on his creation for 10 years. 28 hours a day, 9 days a week. Father of medicine, Hippocrates diagnosed illness by tasting the bodily fluids of his patients. Whoa. He would taste their earwax, their urine, their snot and their pus. Which is also how he came up with a recipe for Marmite. Okay, let's get started. Here are some questions. Mount Rushmore is one of America's most famous landmarks, but can you tell me which 4 people are featured on it?
Oh, it's presidents, isn't it?
President.
Speak up, I don't think they all heard you.
It's DMX.
No one thinks thinks DMX is on Mount Rushmore. Sandi doesn't know what a DMX is.
No.
OK, next question. In 1982, the Ubra Blanca became a national hero in Cuba. Fidel Castro claimed the Ubra Blanca showed the superiority of communism. All I want to know is, what is the Ubra Blanca?
It sounds like a lovely white wine to me.
This is a person.
Oh, no, I want to know what it was.
Siri, Ubra Blanca.
I'm turning off.
Oh, why have you got two phones? I guess one for business. One for business, one for bitches. Am I right?
Meh.
That's another thing Big Narstie and I have got in common. So
wouldn't be the Big Fat Quiz without the children of Mitchell Brook Primary School. They're acting at a historical event. Take a look, tell me what they're doing. Pretty cute.
This is taking ages. This is too expensive! Zitalo, what do we do?
Let's dig under the water.
It'll be much less sweet after Brexit, won't it? That
horribly poignant ending.
Yes.
Take a look at this vintage news report. All I want to know is, what are these people talking about?
No, I didn't find it terribly easy. Yes, I think they'll be all right when we get used to them. They'll be lighter to carry around. I don't think it's as difficult as I thought it might be. It wasn't so bad.
Well, I don't like them very much. This little one is too small and light, but I'm not really keen on the other two.
One would hope that it would be the non-event of 1970 and 1971.
Wow. If I'd ever met that man, I'd have turned. He was sexy, wasn't he?
Yeah, magnetic.
Look at that.
Is that a carry-on film?
That was the news.
No, Peggy Mitchell was buff, did
Peggy
you say?
Peggy Mitchell was that UK's Pamela Anderson.
Yeah, she was hot.
Shamoning.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, the good point well made. OK, so what were they talking about in that news report?
We're going to win.
We got this.
OK.
1971. I wasn't even in the world. I was in my dad's ball bag. I wasn't even...
When you say you were in your dad's ball bag...
I wasn't even in the world yet.
When?
71.
Weren't you?
No, man. I was in my dad's ball bag, just, like, chipping out with the rest of the sperm.
Imagine,
you know I mean?
Imagine the size of your dad's balls.
Also, you can't have that. I wasn't alive then. I know who Alexander the Great was.
Because you were at primary with him.
It's confusing history and memory.
Yeah. OK, now, next question. We're over to the star of Mrs. Brown's Boys, Brendan O'Carroll. Take a look.
Hiya, Jimmy. Now, I played a famous Queen of Dublin, Mrs. Brown. Hello, Jimmy, you're a very bald boy. But I'm here to ask you about another Mrs. Brown, Queen Victoria. She married Prince Albert in 1840. But what tradition did she start on her wedding day?
It's going to be like rice.
Like rice?
Yeah, you know.
Oh, throwing rice.
Shh.
As opposed to the buffet. Yeah.
She looks like she's got a face that's been hit by quite a lot of rice.
The rice.
Some of it's still in the tin.
Do you know what she said about her honeymoon night?
Go on, what did she say?
It was most gratifying.
Prince Albert was the... he was famously... The Prince Albert of Prince Albert fame.
Yes, yeah, indeed.
He wasn't.
Yes.
He's got his old knob.
So why are people called the Prince Albert the Prince Albert?
It's called the Prince Albert because he had a Prince Albert because he was very well endowed and he had to strap it to his leg to not get in the way when he was riding.
What?
That's why he had the Prince Albert.
But, like, if he got an erection midway through the day, did
he would just go, whoa! Hang on, Victoria, we're up.
But who rides a horse, like, forward on the end of your dick anyway?
This boy. Okay. So, you ready for some answers? Of course you are. I asked you which four people are depicted on Mount Rushmore. What did you all put?
Roosevelt, Lincoln, yeah.
So,
Washington, Jefferson.
Yep, and DMX.
DMX!
What you really want?
What you really want?
What do you really want?
Okay, David Frank, did you get this?
We've got Washington, Lincoln, Jefferson, Roosevelt. Everybody's talking about pop mute.
Okay, well, everyone got that right there. Washington, Jefferson, Roosevelt and Lincoln.
Yes.
There they are.
I always think that on the other side of Mount Rushmore, there might be four rock presidents bending over, sticking their heads through Mount Rushmore.
Actually, the other side looks like this. I can show you.
Is that Bruce Willis?
I asked you about the Ubra Blanca. Did you know what the Ubra Blanca was?
We went with cigar, but I thought it might be something to do with, like, Blanca is white, so I did think it may be white wine, but we decided they don't really drink white wine, so we just thought cigar.
It's a good guess, because it's Cuban. It's absolutely wrong. David and Frank, normally I would just read your answer and know what you put, but you've just done some shapes.
Why don't you just you tell us the answer, then we'll tell you what our answer is.
We actually drew the object.
Yeah. No, we went for white cigar.
Because
we went for white as well and cigar.
OK, what have you got? Big Narstie, Katherine?
The Cuban regime and also Che Guevara's cousin.
Yep.
OK, well, they're both wrong. So you're double wrong. It was, in fact, a cow. It was a cow that produced an awful lot of milk and...
Oh, you loved milk!
That is true. Castro was obsessed, so obsessed with milk, the Americans tried to poison him in his daily milkshake.
Swear them!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me that when we were working up the score?
The children of Mitchellbrook Primary School did a lovely play for us.
They were terrific.
What were they acting out? Sandi?
Building the Channel Tunnel.
Of course, the right answer. Did you get this, Katherine? Big Narstie?
The Channel Tunnel for the Eurostar, Disney.
Yeah, Disneyland Paris, homie. Je m'appelle and all of that.
Croissants. That's where it leads.
Je m'appelle all of that croissants. I mean, if you don't speak French, that will have been lost on you, but wow. What the journey he took us on. Frank, what have you got?
Well, we put Channel Bill. That
it
used to be.
It was called the Channel.
Yeah.
Did they call it Channel?
It was called the Channel, yeah.
It was, yeah.
Why is that?
Well, it's quite complicated. It's Channel and Tunnel.
Sacre bleu.
I showed you some vintage news reports. I asked you what everyone was talking about.
Oh, no.
Katherine, Big Narstie, your answer was?
Ball bags.
Yeah.
Ball bags?
Well, you know, it was a joke at first because Big Narstie was not born, neither was I, in 1971. We were in our father's respective ball bags. But then the women were talking about carrying things and they think it was better than they thought it would be and how to lift them. And then we thought, ball bags. This might be about ball bags.
Sandi Jo, what have you got?
We went with decimalisation because that is the correct answer.
It is.
Yes.
You're absolutely right.
What?
Instead of P, we used to have D, and D was denarius, which is the original Roman coin that's...
I always wondered that. You're a genius.
She's a genius, but she didn't know about that fucking cow, though,
no,
did she?
No, I...
You don't know nothing about no Cuban cows.
No.
Yeah.
Okay, so Brendan O'Carroll asked you what wedding tradition Queen Victoria started. What did you put?
We thought it was maybe throwing rice.
Apparently that's an old thing from the Middle Ages and it represents fertility. The rice actually represents the...
Oh, you're joking.
Yeah.
Imagine if you came and it was confetti.
I bet you when clowns ejaculate, that's what happens.
It was the cow.
That'd be a great
great Channel 5 documentary when clowns ejaculate.
So I can tell you it's not the confetti. That was an old thing from the Middle Ages. So what did you put, Katherine, Big Narstie?
Wow.
What have you done to Big Narstie? Also, why doesn't he make any noise when he laughs? I'm on the other end of that spectrum. I make too much noise when I laugh, but that was just a wobble when you laugh.
For some reason, he's laughing at the thought of a Cuban cow ejaculating, and I don't...
Look, he's gone. Do you remember before he started laughing when he had eyes? He used to have eyes. Oh, there they are again.
No, but they could see the tears.
I'm so sorry.
You know that cows are female, right?
No, they've gone again.
He's making a noise now, though. It's kind of like...
Oh, that was good.
I have no idea what was funny about that, but something happened. OK, what did you put, Katherine?
It's not that funny. Rice tastes a lot better than what actually comes out. I moved to change it.
Stay away from sugar puffs and asparagus.
Please.
What does sugar puffs do?
Eat sugar puffs for 2 weeks and go for a wee, you'll understand.
For 2 weeks? Have you eaten sugar puffs for 2 weeks?
David, you don't get a figure like that not eating sugar puffs for 2 weeks. That's a man that's lived on sugar puffs.
Yeah, it must have been an extraordinary piss as well.
Katherine Big.
The big man pointed out that Queen Victoria couldn't leave the country to go on honeymoon, could she? So she started the tradition of lifting the veil and then shagging at home. Mm.
Why couldn't she leave the country?
Because she had to be queen.
Because the film on Channel 4, when they went to go, she's like, I have to look after the country. So we'll just stay in bed for a couple of more days.
Yeah.
And she was getting that work.
I mean that...
Staycation.
I'm going to say wrong on a number of levels. A, she could leave the country, and B, no.
Can I just say that Big Narstie is actually right? Because what happened was he wanted to go on honeymoon for several weeks and go to Germany, and she said, I have to stay and be queen, and they had 2 days in Windsor Castle instead.
Thank you!
Well, the unfortunate thing is that is not the answer to a question that we had in the quiz.
Well, the answer to the question in life.
Sandi, Joe, what have you put?
Well, Sandi wrote this, wearing white.
It's absolutely the right answer.
Yes!
It's
a
lace white wedding dress. Yes, correct. There she is. OK, so at the end of the first round, the scores are Sandi and Joe have 7 points, Katherine and Big Narstie have 5, David and Frank have 6. Join us after the break for more Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Well, what else are you going to do? Talk to your family? I didn't think so. Quiz of Everything.
Yes, I love quizzes.
We love
Jimmy. This next round is all about music, so it doesn't matter if you like the Spice Girls and Justin Bieber or actual music, there's something here for everyone. At a gig in 1982, Ozzy Osbourne caused controversy after biting the head off a bat. It looked confused, smelt disgusting, and I was worried it'd give me rabies, said the bat. In the UK, Oasis had 8 number one singles, 8 number one albums, and 828 serious fights about nothing in a car park. Okay, to ask our first music question, it's over to Stacey Solomon.
Hi, Jimmy. This question is about one of my all-time heroes, Madonna. She had a massive hit in 1990 with Vogue, and the rap in the middle lists 16 ladies with an attitude and fellows that were in the mood. But can your teams remember 3 of them?
OK, so she wants to know Madonna's song, Vogue. She listed 16 people in the rap in that song. You just have to name 3 of them. Couldn't be easier. Great. All right, next question. I'm going to play you 3 pieces of music. All I want to know is what connects these 3 pieces of music, OK? Here we go. Oh, OK, three pieces of music there. You heard Seven Nation Army by the White Stripes. It was Go West, covered there by the Pet Shop Boys, and it was Bread of Heaven by whoever writes hymns. The hymn writer guy.
OK.
I thought that was Big Narstie.
Oh, thanks.
Let's hang out. I think we should hang out.
You're not helping. What kind of thing?
I don't know. I'm just flirting with Big Narstie now.
Okay. Do not flirt with Big Narstie. He's mine. Am I right?
Oh.
I would like to broker that sex tape.
OK, for our next question, it's over to the Channel 4 newsroom where Jon Snow is reporting on a classic song. I just want to know, what's he talking about?
Environmental health officers in the United States are investigating a dairy factory after reports that local men were exhibiting peculiar symptoms after consuming their products. According to eyewitnesses, one drink in particular was making the guys go crazy and in some cases lose their minds. The substance is said to be extremely addictive, with large numbers of men congregating in the yard outside the factory. Researchers have suggested that the company's process may involve warming up the raw ingredients. But in a defiant statement, the company's owner refused to divulge her recipes, saying that she'd have to charge for the story, and warned investigators that thieves get caught. She had a bullish message to any potential market rivals, saying, "Damn right, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours." The case continues. Back to you, Jimmy.
I like that. Thank you, Jon Snow.
There's a character called Jon Snow in Game of Thrones.
Come on.
There is, isn't there? Oh, and again. Oh, fantastic.
Come on.
Yeah. David Baddiel, he's down with the kids, if anyone's wondering.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
I've always thought that's a bit weird, though. It's like in Star Trek, if there was a character called Fiona Bruce.
In history, Jon Snow is the person who brought clean water to the UK, to London.
Really?
Mm. So there are lots of Jon Snows. I think it's... I'm going to go with Common.
If you want to know about Common, Frank Skinner.
There was a fast bowler who played for Sussex and England called Jon Snow, also.
See? Common.
OK, well, what was that Jon Snow off of Channel 4 News talking about? OK, take a look at your screens. I've got five dolls, all based on famous pop stars. Who are they? Couldn't be easier.
Oh, I know that one.
I mean, they're almost like photographs.
One of them is Joe Lycett, definitely. That one on the right-hand side top is definitely Joe Lycett.
That is actually what Joe Lycett uses on his Grindr profile. OK, I'm going to show you three album covers. They've all been subtly improved. All you've got to do is name all three albums. Take a point for each on this, but there's the first one. What album is that? Here's the second one. If anything, more beautiful than the first. And the third one.
Oh, I know that one.
Thank you. Thank you, one man that whistles sarcastically.
I don't know, though. I don't know.
Okay. You ready for some answers?
Yes.
All right. So, Stacey Solomon wanted to know three ladies with attitude and fellas that were in the mood. What did you all put?
We put Greta, Garbo, and Monroe, Dietrich, and DiMaggio. And then we quit. Chilling. Get that bag.
Do you know the whole thing?
I know mostly Cardi B lyrics.
Okay, David, Frank, did you get this?
We got Greta Garbo, Fred Astaire, and Jon Snow, the Sussex and England fast bowler. We could only remember Garbo and Astaire.
Garbo and Astaire, okay.
I don't know if I've ever listened to the song any further than that.
Do you want to have a listen?
Yeah.
Greta Garbo and Monroe, Dietrich and DiMaggio. Marlon Brando, Jimmy Dean, on the cover of a magazine. Grace Kelly, Harlow Jean, picture of a beauty queen. Jean Kelly, Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers, dance on air. They had style, they had grace, Rita Hayworth gave good face. Lauren, Catherine, Manitou, Betty Davis, we love you. Ladies with an attitude, fellas that were in the mood. Don't just stand there, let's get to it, strike a pose.
Did you get all of these?
Which favourite writing we got? one, two, three, four, five, six, seven of them, but then we stopped writing because you asked another question.
OK, so 3 points, 3 points, 2 points. OK. OK, I asked you what links Seven Nation Army, Go West and Bread of Heaven. What did you get?
Jeremy Corbyn.
You're partly right, but you don't get a point for that. Sandi, Joe?
We just put gay, all gay.
How come I only get half a point?
Because you didn't get it right. You don't get a half a point, you get no points.
Yeah.
You didn't get it right. I don't know how else to express that.
Well, you said I kind of got it right, though.
Well, you kind of, like, you were on the right lines, but you didn't get it right.
You're giving mixed messages.
David Frank, what did you put?
We put their old football chants.
And you are absolutely right. We can hear the football chants.
Oh, OK.
Of Heaven.
Yeah, that wasn't the original version, though. Oh.
The one he played for Go West, I can't remember what it was, but it's not the best one. The best one is Your Shit and You Know You Are. That is the best.
That's the classic.
That's the classic, because it's an incredible thing to say as an insult, isn't it?
Yeah.
You're shit. Not only are you shit, at heart you know that about yourself.
So what are your favourites?
I think the best football chant ever was one that West Brom used to do, was "We will follow the Albion over land and sea and water."
You saw Jon Snow reporting on a famous song. Did you all get it? Milkshake by Khaleesi.
Yep.
Yeah, I think we did.
Let's go over to Jon for the reveal. I showed you five pop star dolls and asked you who they were supposed to be. What did you put?
I was just watching that clip of Jon Snow, and I'm going to be honest, there's some confetti down here. Now.
Yes, a clown just passed.
Clown rice.
Clown's rice.
Okay, so I think you all got the first one, so let's go to Sandi and Joe.
Sonny and Cher.
Sonny and Cher, yes, that is Sonny and Cher. Let's have a look at those side by side.
It's a good Sonny.
Mm. Yeah.
The Sonny's not bad at all. Okay, so the next one, Katherine, Big Narstie, did you get the next one, the top right? The
We're
blonde?
Very confused about that creepy looking doll.
Is it the boy from Bros?
I'm afraid you're not right there. David Frank, who did you think it was?
We thought it was Matt.
We thought it might, but then I thought Matt Goss probably hasn't got a doll.
Well, he might have done at the time, but he doesn't have one now. It's actually, and you'll kick yourself when you see it.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's sort of Ronan Keating.
That doll does not look anything like whoever that man you said he was.
You don't know who Ronan Keating is?
Ronan Keating,
OK.
Which one is he? Well, no, the next one, OK, bottom left.
It looks like my...
That's him.
What
oh, my God.
Was,
Ronan
was...
Keating's here, everyone.
What band was he in?
He was on Boyzone.
Boyzone.
And,
goes...
and they sound like this.
Life is a roller coaster.
I didn't actually realise I could do that.
Okay, well, next one, bottom left. Who do you think that was?
No idea.
A young P. Diddy.
Oh,
it
yes.
might be George Michael.
Bottom left.
God rest his soul.
Bottom left.
Yeah, bottom left. George Michael.
You know, it's the black guy, you know that, ain't it?
They're supposed to be bad dolls.
I can tell you it is, in fact, MC Hammer.
Oh!
Oh. MC Hammer!
Of course!
All right, next one. So who's
Justin
this?
Timberlake, Justin Timberlake.
Yeah. Do you not think that doll looks like his brains on the outside of his head?
But so does Justin Timberlake.
Oh, fine.
Well, when you look at this picture, and you're absolutely right, it is Justin Timberlake, but this guy's a heartthrob. I mean...
That rice is on the boil again?
Rice is on the boil, I like.
And the next day is the Rice Krispies on the sheet.
Okay, I showed you three album covers that have all been subtly improved.
Yeah.
Okay, did you get the albums?
Are they all greatest hits?
They are not all greatest hits.
We went for One Step Beyond for the
One Step Beyond is absolutely right. Let's see. So that's me, and this is Madness and their version of that. Okay, One Step Beyond. So you get a point there.
Then we couldn't get the middle one, but we thought it was Katy Perry's I Kissed a Girl was the last one.
Katy Perry's It's One of the Boys by Katy Perry is the album.
It's not called I Kissed a Girl.
The single was I Kissed a Girl.
Oh.
And then the middle one...
Celine. Is it Celine?
It is Celine Dion. Did you get the album title?
we only got the people, we didn't get any titles.
Let's talk about love. So that's the end of the music round. Let's take a look at the scores. I can tell you, bringing up the rear, Big Narstie and Katherine have 12. Dave and Frank have 14. Sandi and Joe have 14. Join us after the break for more Big Fat Fun. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. The next round is all about film and TV. What's not to love about TV? Hollyoaks. It's Hollyoaks.
Of that joke.
Yeah.
All right.
In Forrest Gump, Tom Hanks plays a backward simpleton who often wears a red hat. And it was so popular in America, some years later, they elected someone similar as president. In 1960, the film Psycho was released. My girlfriend always gets really annoyed because whenever she's in the shower, I copy that famous scene from Psycho. She'll be standing there under the water and secretly, without her knowing, I'll fuck my dead mum. Okay, time for some film and TV questions. Take a look at these short clips from classic movies. Can you tell me what links them? You saw a thrilling fight scene from Return of the Jedi, a spectacular epic battle in Gondor from Lord of the Rings, and Michael Keaton's gothic Batman coolly throwing an evil clown over a railing. What links those three clips? Mm. OK, next question. When Channel 5 News launched on the 31st of March 1997, Kirsty Young did something that was a first on British TV. What was it? No, she didn't do that on Channel 5 News, Big Narstie. That would have been newsworthy in and of itself.
You know Anthony Perkins doesn't fuck his dead mum in Psycho? That's not what happens.
you know that massive laugh you gave me on that joke? Take it back.
He dresses up as his mum and kills people.
Yeah.
Unless there's a bit I've missed.
There's a director's cut.
Yeah.
OK, next question. But I love the fact... I love the fact you couldn't let that go.
No, I couldn't.
I love everything about you, but I love the fact that there's a pedant within you that just...
Yeah, also, you know what? There's also a pedant that calls it pedant.
Unbelievable. OK. And next is over to comedy legend Eric Idle.
Ooh. Hello, Jimmy. Now, I've been reminiscing about the Monty Python years while writing my new autobiography, Always Look on the Bright Side of Life, and all the amazing things that we achieve. But it's the achievements of another group I want to ask the teams about, the Romans. Can your teams tell me three things the Romans did for us, according to the life of Brian?
OK, so what did the Romans do for us? Three things the Romans did for us.
I'll read it out.
Frank, what were the Romans like?
I found them very intrusive.
Take a look at these four shapes. All I want you to do is tell me what they are. Couldn't be easier.
Are they the different signs in non-binary toilets?
OK, you've all got something. Famous films often have different titles when released in non-English-speaking countries. So I'm going to give you four translated titles. I just want you to tell me what the original films were called. There's a point for each. OK, so I need the original title of... Mum, I Missed the Plane, the first one. The Teeth of the Sea, it's the second one. Electronic Murderer. And Father Bastard.
Father Bastard, that's just a biopic of my dad, I think.
Mum, I Missed the Plane, The Teeth of the Sea, Electronic Murderer, and Father Bastard.
I got snacks, Narstie, don't worry. I'm too late.
Let's not answer that.
Can I have the fourth one?
What was the fourth one, darling?
Shh.
Oh, is Big Narstie sleeping?
No, he's not. He's just fabulous.
Yeah.
OK, ready for some answers? I showed you three scenes from iconic Hollywood movies. I asked you what connected them. What did you all put?
Screaming.
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 Oh, no!
Good versus evil.
John Williams, we put.
John Williams, I can tell you, incorrect. I can tell you good versus evil, incorrect. Scream, absolutely the right answer.
Ow!
Well, I'll tell you... They all feature the same scream, a scream sound effect that has appeared in over 150 films to date. It's called the Wilhelm scream. That's what it's called, the Wilhelm scream, because the character that used it was called Wilhelm, and then they just kept on using it. It's the best ever scream. I think I'm a... I'm just about to get a clown rise. Okay. I asked you what Kirsty Young did for the first time on Channel 5 News in 1997. Katherine, Big Narstie, what did you book?
It's our turn.
Big Narstie, are you going to sleep?
It's our turn.
Huh?
Are you all right, Narstie?
Yeah, you know I was doing some proper white people joke. I was lost.
Okay, let's get on with the quiz, everyone. Let's get on with the quiz. Okay, so what have you put for this one, Katherine?
So that's Kirsty Young. So what did she do for the first time on Channel 5 News?
Swore?
Yeah, she swore. She went, this is the fucking news. No, she didn't swear. What did you, Sandi, what do you think?
She stood up.
It was a huge deal at the time.
We said stood up as well.
Okay, well, she read the news standing up, so points to you, points to you. No points here. Eric Idle asked you to name three things the Romans did for us. What did you put?
Sanitation, aqueducts, roads.
Okay, ooh. What did you put, Katherine, Big Narstie?
Roman walls. We also had aqueducts and the baths. And then Big Narstie added that they were gay.
That's the Greeks, I think.
Via the Romans.
Yeah.
Okay, you got two, Sandi? What did you get?
We put roads and architecture. We thought we'd cover all of architecture. And then we put coinage, because we couldn't remember what it said in the film.
So 1 point, 2 points, 3 points. OK, I asked you what these four shapes were. Sandi Toksvig, I imagine you got this.
She bloody did as well.
It's the aerials from the Teletubbies.
Is there nothing you don't know?
We got it too.
Did you get as well?
What, tiki-wiki la la and po?
Yeah!
OK, and you got what, Big Narstie?
I thought they were road signs. Like, one is yield, the other one's carry on, the other one is there's a highway that... You know the ones that go up in the sky? And then a roundabout.
That's a
have you got a driving licence?
No.
I'm going to take it away.
I already lost it. But it wasn't for misreading road signs.
Tinky Winky was the one who was accused of being gay by Jerry Falwell, the evangelical preacher, because he had the triangle on his head and he was purple, which is apparently a gay colour, and carried a handbag.
And he was sucking loads of dicks. Imagine getting a blowy off her.
Do you know, imagine, I'm really what? Trying. I'm
you know,
really
trying. Do you know what would be lovely? It'd be lovely to have something to hold on to.
Yeah.
That's a little handrail.
Tubby custard.
Oh, these people are sick. These people are sick. They are sick, my lord.
I gave you four translated movie titles. What were the originals? OK, so the first one was Mum, I Missed the Plane.
Home Alone.
It was, of course, it was Home Alone. You didn't buy anything.
Ooh, game.
Okay, so no point, point, point. The next one, that was the French title for Home Alone. The Teeth of the Sea, you all got this, right?
Jaws.
The French title for Jaws, of course. Electronic Murderer.
Sarah Connor, come with me if you want to live.
Get your job off.
I'm not Sarah Connor.
Terminator.
Terminator.
Terminator, Terminator, of course. And you put Joe?
RoboCop.
Oh.
He's not a murderer. He's law enforcement.
Yeah, well.
Justifiable homicide.
Oh, that's...
Good point.
OK, Father Bastard.
I put Daddy Dickhead. I panicked, and I thought that might be a film.
That is a film you should write. What did you get, Katherine? Big Narstie?
Bad Santa.
OK, and David, Frank?
I thought it was the Father Brown, the popular Kenneth Moore black and white movie based on the G.K. Chesterton story.
I wish it was that.
Yeah, that's the right answer.
It was called Father Brown, but...
What was it?
It was Bad Santa. Of course, yay! It was Bad Santa. So, points on that, 1-4-3.
Whoa! So we're like back in the game.
Okay. Time now for a quick bonus round. We asked one of Britain's most distinguished actors, Charles Dance, to read a selection of film reviews that were all posted online. All you need to do is work out what films he's talking about. OK, here's the first one.
2.5 hours of utter crap. Basically, two monkeys having a barney over a bone. Then one of them touches a giant space Kit Kat. 1 star.
OK, so which classic of cinema is Charles Dance talking about there? You've all got to write down the answer.
Two monkeys having a barney over a bone.
OK, all right, let's have a look, see if you got it right. So you've put what, David and Frank?
2001 A Space Odyssey.
OK, you've gone for...
Planet of the Apes.
Planet of the Apes. And
yeah, we did Planet of the Apes as well.
Yeah, Planet of the Apes. And the answer is 2001 A Space Odyssey.
Oh.
Oh. Very nice. OK, next one, over to Charles Dance.
Modern-day Cinderella with blowjobs instead of slippers. 1 star.
I tell you, it's not a panto I take my kids to.
No. No.
OK, let's have a look, see what you got. Sandi?
Pretty Joe? Woman.
Pretty Woman.
That's my favourite film, you know?
Is it?
I used to watch that Marty Mother all the time in that. That's a powerful film, blood.
Is that why you don't kiss on the mouth? All Pretty Woman, all makes sense. You don't kiss on the mouth? Really?
No, I'm a titty man.
Oh, Sandi.
Oh. Honestly, God, I felt that from here.
I'm so sorry you had to hear that, but you did ask. David and Frank, you got...
Pretty Woman.
You got Pretty Woman, OK. Katherine, Big Narstie, what did you go for?
Whoever 50 Shades of Grey in my life.
No. OK. It was, of course, Pretty Woman. OK, back over to Charles Dance for the next one.
Please note, there is no full frontal male nudity to be found here. But the rear exposure is glorious. 5 stars.
So, no full frontal nudity, but the rear exposure is fantastic. OK, have you all got something?
Yes, Jimmy
Carr. OK, Joe, what have you got?
We wrote down The Full Monty.
The Full Monty. OK, well, that is disappointing. You wrote David and Frank?
Well, we wrote that, but I thought it might be Magic Mike. But we've written Full Monty.
What did you write, Katherine Big Narstie?
We were about to write Full Monty, weren't we?
Yeah, then we put Magic Mike.
Well, you were absolutely bloody right to write Magic Mike.
Yeah! Good job.
OK, well, let's see how you're doing after that. In last place, Katherine and Big Narstie with 19. Just ahead, Sandi and Joe with 20. David and Frank have got 24. Join us after the break for more Big Fat Fun. The Big Fat Quiz of Everything. The next round is all about science, or as Donald Trump calls it, fake news bullshit. Where would we be without science and technology? Well, modern-day Norfolk gives you a pretty good idea. The first animal to orbit Earth was Laika the dog, and it's believed Laika's final thought was, how fucking far did they throw this stick? OK, time for some science questions. In the 1960s, NASA researcher Margaret Howell Lovett entered into an intimate relationship with a co-worker named Peter. She was trying to teach him English. Why was it controversial?
Oh.
Which beauty product was originally derived from a substance found in rotten sausages? Katherine Ryan's specialist area.
I don't know what that means.
Rotten sausages.
Beauty substance.
OK, now it's time to go to local entrepreneur and corrupt FM owner, Chabuddy G.
Yes,
Chabuddy.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, I've run several successful businesses in my time, including Chabuddy's Worldwide Internet Cafe, where you could spend hours surfing for all sorts of animal pics. Not in a weird way. But it's one animal in particular I want to ask about. Can your teams tell me why this dog found internet fame in July 2010?
OK, so why did that dog find internet fame?
2010.
I don't really like the idea of animals. I like the idea of my cat being an influencer. I think that's a weird idea. Like, my cat is going to influence other cats to, like, meow for ages to go out and then come straight back in again. That's going to really piss off lots of other owners.
It'll be fine.
My son, who's six, he's got cat allergy, and a few weeks ago he woke up with quite a heavy cold, and he said to me, do you think maybe I dreamt about a cat?
Aww. What a fucking idiot.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what profession uses tools of the trade, including the brain scoop, artificial tongues, ear liners, fleshing balls, and the eager beaver tabletop flesher?
I love an eager beaver.
Sorry, did I say that out loud?
Question five, okay. Time for a say what you see. I love these. Okay, they're very satisfying. Take a look at these pictures. All I want you to do is tell me what moment from the world of science are they spelling out?
You know, you mentioned Laika before, the Russian dog that went into space. You know, it died in space. It didn't come back. Apparently, they did that thing of leaving the window just a little bit open.
Okay, let's have some answers, okay? I asked you what was controversial about NASA scientist Margaret Howell Lovett's intimate relationship with a co-worker. Big Narstie and Katherine, I'm interested in your answer. Why did you think her relationship with the co-worker was controversial?
Well, he's a black man.
I'm going to say no. You put David Frank?
Peter was a dolphin, is that right?
We put dolphin, but it wasn't the fact so much that he was a dolphin as the nature of their relationship.
And what have you written there?
I didn't think at any point in my life I'd be writing on a little screen and Sandi Toksvig would lean in and say, put in brackets, hand jobs.
Absolutely bloody right to. Take a look.
But as Peter's urges grew more frequent, the process of transporting him down to the two female dolphins to satisfy him proved disruptive. And Margaret felt the best way of focusing his mind back on the lessons was to relieve his desires herself manually.
It was just easier to incorporate that and let it happen. It was very precious. It was very gentle. Peter was right there. He knew that I was right there. Again, it was sexual on his part. It was not sexual on mine. Sensuous, perhaps. It would just become part of what was going on, like an itch. Just get rid of that. We'll scratch it and we'll be done, move on. And that's really all it was. I was there to get to know Peter. That was part of Peter.
Well, yeah. I was about to say it was a different time, isn't she?
Yeah, I mean, you're probably wondering what wanking off a dolphin's got to do with NASA.
So,
what are you two doing?
We're celebrating that we got hand jobs into a show. It's OK. Karen, do you want one?
If you bought a hamper?
Yeah, I've got a picnic.
Just a couple of basic pictures.
See? Cheers, darling. Well done.
Cheers. Can I just ask? So that is great, but are they going to get more points for hand jobs? Because we did say Peter was a dolphin.
You get a point, you get a point. Yeah, you're all absolutely
Surely
right.
Surely we get more points for the actual nature of the relationship.
Well, no, because the question was, why was it controversial? It was with a dolphin. OK,
you
let's have the next
dolphins
question.
Dolphins do apparently assault humans.
Have they got normal... What if their cock look like?
What does their cock look like?
Yeah, but when you think of flipper, you don't think him with a cock, do you? You think of flipper. You know what I mean?
So like, he is a mammal, though.
What are you opening?
Yeah, what's going on?
Pork pie. Do you want some?
I'm probably all right, because I'm sort of right in the middle of work, but...
Do you want some? Yeah, pork some. Pie?
Yeah, I'd love some.
Pork?
Yes, don't do that.
I've got a basket of treats as well! Yes. Big Narstie, I love you so much. I want you to stay focused on the quiz. I'm not prepared to give you a hand job.
Bring one.
And so instead, I brought all
did anyone
your
bring anything for Grandad and Grandad?
I'm having some pork pie.
What would you like to eat first?
I'm going to smack these Cheetos.
Next question. I'll talk over the unwrapping of food. I asked you what beauty product was originally derived from the substance found in rotten sausages, or possibly Sandy's pork pie. What did you put?
Botox.
And then I put in brackets hand jobs. So...
OK, yeah. I'll give you that, Botox. David and Frank, you put?
We put Botox.
Botox. And Catherine, who knows more about plastic surgery than anyone?
Well, you said beauty, and, like, then I thought Botox is botulism from cows, I thought, they said.
Well, they first got it from rotten sausages.
Hold on. So you're telling me there's gal walking right now with pork and apple sausages in their face?
Next thing, OK, so you all got, what, Botox? Ah, you got it wrong, Catherine, who knew?
I can't believe it.
Your buddy G wanted to know why this dog found internet fame in July 2010. What did you put?
It's the very first photo on Instagram.
That is absolutely the right answer. Bradley. Why not brackets and jobs? What did you put, David?
You got it wrong.
I thought, you know those dogs that say I love you on the internet? They go, I love you. I thought it might
be.
That
is a very good impression.
Okay, I sadly know. First ever picture on Instagram. What did you put? You put space something.
We thought maybe he went to space. My daughters between them have hundreds of thousands of Instagram followers, and this dog is trash.
Okay, quiz Jenna. I asked you what profession uses the following: brain scoop, artificial tongues, airliners, fleshing balls, and the eager beaver tabletop flesher. Did you get it?
It's taxidermy.
Taxidermy. Brackets, hand jobs.
Okay, finally, there was a set where you see. What did you all put?
We were so close. I think we might
Okay,
have
so
it.
What have you got, Catherine? If you think you're close, what have you got?
Well, we definitely knew meteor, dinosaur, and Big Narstie has been sparring a lot in the gym. So that one photo, we didn't know. Fight, box, we put box. Meteor, box, dinosaur.
Meteor, box, dinosaur. So when she hits the thing, you thought it was boxing, did you? When it hits it.
Oh, the meteor. Oh!
Okay, what did you put, Sandy? Did you get
meteor strikes dinosaurs.
Brackets, right. Hand jobs.
Hand jobs.
But the meteor didn't hit the dinosaurs, did it?
It hit the tall ones.
It hit me. I wondered if it was a very, very hot day and one dinosaur said to a crowd, let's go and stand in that ever-increasing circle of shade. And that's how so many of them got hit.
Meteor hits dinosaurs. So, points.
Yeah!
Points. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for a special guest. Please, will you welcome star of Strictly, and this morning, it's Dr. Ranj.
Hello. How are you?
I'm very well.
So, a little known fact, the last time that Joe and Catherine and I were in the same room, Catherine and I had a selfie with a picture of Joe in a magazine.
Yep.
I've still got said magazine.
Yes. What magazine? What magazine
it's
was
Joe? It's quite soggy, but I've still got it.
I love you,
Ron. I must say, that is quite a fetching bomber you have there, sir. Very nice. I know, brown person said bomber, don't panic.
Quite good. OK, now, you've got a question for our teams.
I do.
Science round. Doctor, come on. Question.
OK, so, as a doctor, I need to know a lot about the human body and how it works. Mm-hmm. Well, at least until Google came along. So, on each of your models, I need you to locate two muscles and a bone. Steady. Two muscles that I would like you to identify are the rectus abdominis,
yep,
the humerus, and finally the rhomboids.
Okay, so jump up, grab pen. They've got pens on them, and you can just write on the models. Okay, so the first one is the
rectus abdominis.
Rectus abdominis. So that's draw the rectus abdominis. wherever you think the rectus, and try and spell rectus abdominis while you're at it. Why not?
Where do you get these outfits from?
Where do I get them? From my own personal collection. Okay. I'm going to have to hurry up on this.
They all look like diseased sperm.
OK, so, Dr. Range, talk us through it. So, what was the first one you wanted?
Rectus abdominis.
And where is the rectus abdominis? Show us.
Do you know what? You actually got it right. It is these two muscles. It's your abdominal muscles, your six-pack or barrel.
OK, how did they do?
They should get a point.
It's kind of... There's
OK, you're the right area. And what about these guys?
There we go.
A, B.
OK, and then what was the second thing?
Humerus.
Humerus? Where was the humerus?
We thought the humerus was just here.
Oops.
That is a humerus place to point. Yeah. There's no getting away from it. OK, where did boom, you think boom. The humerus was? You thought it was the funny bone?
And you guys said it was just there. It's actually the bone that joins your shoulder to your elbow. So it's that bit.
So we don't get it for that?
I don't think that's
Did we get it right?
I mean, it's the big fat quiz of everything. I mean, it's not the final medical exam. I'm not going to go into practice off the back of this. I think we could probably say the elbow is where it starts. This is giving them a point, doctor. OK, and then what was the last thing?
It's your rhomboids. Now, this is actually quite difficult.
Is that completely wrong?
That's totally wrong. Okay. Your rhomboids are actually two sets of deep muscles that run from your spinal column to the edge of your scapula. So they are just here and just here.
Are they on your shoulder?
Just behind your shoulder.
No, no points there for the front.
Oh, no, they're at the back.
No, we did an arrow there to point all the way up to where the rhomboids are.
OK, so the points at the end of that, so you get 1 point, 2 points, 2 points.
That's it.
Excellent, OK. All right, everyone, sit down. OK, let's see what that's done to the scores. I can tell you that Katherine and Big Narstie have 22, Sandi and Joe have 26, and David and Frank have 30. We're going to take a short break while I get Dr. Range to look at this rash. See you in a few. Thank you very much for coming in. Back to the Big Fat Quiz of everything. The next round is all about people. People are amazing. So much so that I've asked Geppetto to turn me into one. Gwyneth Paltrow's lifestyle website, Goop, recommended women steam clean their vaginas. No wonder Chris Martin left her. He was trying to use that kettle to make a cup of tea. OK, time for some more Big Fat Questions. OK, they're all about people this time. For the first one, it's over to Basil Brush.
Hello, 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 Mr. Jimmy. Basil Brush here. Now, I'm known for being a sophisticated gentleman about town, but it's another classy gent I want to talk about. James Bond actor Pierce Brosnan was widely reported to be banned from doing something during his tenure in the iconic role. Can your teams tell me what it was? Boom, boom, everybody!
OK, so you'd be able to work this out. So
Pierce Brosnan was not allowed
He wasn't allowed to do a very specific thing the whole time he played Bond.
Acting.
OK, take a look at these three musicians. I want to know what links them all. It's Michelle Stevenson, Dick Evans and Stephen Tintin Duffy. What links those musicians?
They're all white.
One of them's quite orangey. OK. Kim Kardashian. Someone's perked up.
Yes. My favourite... I mean, my middle daughter.
Tell me your favourite. OK. Kim Kardashian is Hollywood royalty, no doubt. Can you tell me who her godfather is?
Yep.
Yes.
This woman here is a Kardashian.
That's Kim Kardashian.
That's Kim Kardashian. Well, hello.
No, Sandi, just above there is her face.
Oh, I see. Wow.
I believe Sandi just motorboated. What a wonderful thing. Gary Kremen invented something that directly resulted in his girlfriend leaving him. What was it? Just write it down. If you think you got the answer, write it down. Wow. That's me with a porn addiction, I think. Oh, the look.
I've genuinely not seen porn. Swear.
Ever?
Ever. Mm-mm.
So you've been in more porn than you've seen?
Yeah, that's why I can't watch it.
Yeah,
I don't want to meet my real dad that way.
And finally, whose feet are these? It's our Quentin Tarantino question. Whose feet are these?
It's that, isn't it?
Do you think? Do you know?
Okay, you're ready for some big fat answers. Basil Brush wanted to know what Pierce Brosnan was not allowed to do while he was Bond. What did you put?
Drink gin, we thought.
Drink gin?
Because he has to drink vodka the whole time.
Okay, it's a pretty good
That's
answer.
That's a no, though, isn't it?
What did you put? David Frank?
We didn't know.
I thought he might not be allowed to have a tattoo because he has to appear sort of naked-ish.
It's another good answer. It's a very good thought. It's not right. Catherine, Big Narstie?
Smoke.
We thought perhaps he wasn't allowed to go to casinos.
Oh, God, that is... I mean, I'm tempted to give you that. He wasn't allowed to wear tuxedos in other films.
Oh. Why were you tempted to give me that?
Casinos kind of felt like it was kind of along those kind of lines.
Just because you wear tuxedos to a casino, the people in my town don't even put pants on.
So, no points there. OK, so I asked you what linked Michelle Stevenson, Dick Evans and Stephen Tintin Duffy. What did you put?
I just thought they looked like very similar people and thought maybe they're the same person.
It's a great answer. I mean, would that it were true. No. What did you get? Big Narstie, you're in the music business.
I don't know these people.
OK, no one's accusing you of anything. David Frank?
Well, I think... I don't really know about the first two, but Stephen Tintin Duffy, I think, was originally a member of Duran Duran. So I think they're all in famous bands, but not the famous people in the, who were originally in the band.
That's exactly the right answer, yeah. I can tell you that Stephen Tintin Duffy was replaced by Simon Le Bon in Duran Duran. Michelle Stevenson was replaced by Emma Bunton in the Spice Girls.
Oh, no.
And then Dick Evans was an early member of U2.
Oh, blimey. Yeah. What does Dick do now?
I imagine U2's laundry. I don't know. I think he's the Edge's brother. I think they're still connected to the band.
Can I tell you a story about the Edge?
Yeah.
I met him once a long time
ago.
It's
not a great story.
No, it's not the end of the story. And I was with a woman I was going out with at the time who didn't know much about pop music. And he came up and at this party and said, "Hello, I'm the Edge," right? And she went, "Pardon?" Which you might, really. And he went really red and he said, "I'm the Edge." And she said, "Sorry, what was your name again?" And he went really, really red. He said, "Well, my real name is whatever it is, David Evans, but people call me The Edge." And it was kind of really weird. Like, no one had ever asked him before that his name is like an abstract concept. It's not really a name, right? No one had pointed that out. So I kind of pushed her away and said, "This is embarrassing." I said, "Sarah, I was like, do you really not know, you know, who that was?" And she said, "Oh, no, I think I do now. But what I thought he was saying was that his name was Reg."
OK, I asked you who was Kim Kardashian's godfather. Joe, Sandy?
Donald Trump, we put, because I don't know who these people are in the first place. So who their godparents are was a mystery to me.
It's a bloody good guess. I imagine he knew them back in the day. I think there's photographs of them together, but it's not Donald Trump. Let's give this one to Katherine Ryan, because she deserves it.
I misunderstood the question. I thought you said father.
Yeah.
I put Michael Jackson. And then my associate, Big Narstie, said it's O.J. Simpson. So we put O.J. Simpson.
You got this wrong. You got the Botox question wrong. Who are you? I feel like I don't even know you anymore.
Quiz Jenner. Is it not Michael Jackson or O.J. Simpson?
OK, it is Oronthal J. Simpson.
Oh, good! You got it!
That's the right answer.
OK.
That's the right answer as well. Thank you, David.
Oh, goodness!
O.J. Simpson is the godfather. You know, a godfather is meant to sort of guide you morally through life.
Yeah.
Great choice, people. Great choice. OK, this round not going brilliantly for Sandy and Joe.
Why don't you rub it in, prick?
I asked you what Gary Kremen invented that directly led to his girlfriend leaving him. Joe Lycett, did you get the answer?
We thought maybe... Well, I thought specifically Pornhub, but, Sandy thought maybe internet porn.
Mm.
Internet porn is not quite the right answer. Catherine, Big Narstie?
A Vibrio.
A sex toy.
You think you invented a sex toy? That is not the right answer, but again, good answer.
I know the answer to this.
David and Frank?
It's funny, I think. He invented Match.com, didn't he? And brilliantly, his girlfriend then went on Match.com and found another boyfriend.
That's absolutely right, brilliant. I showed you a photo of a pair of feet. All I want to know is whose feet?
Libertas. The,
Statue of Liberty.
Libertas. I mean, that's a very classy way of getting the answer absolutely right.
Wow!
David and Frank?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was at the Statue of Liberty 2 weeks ago, and it's the first time I ever realised that one of the feet are slightly raised.
Oh, no, she's walking forward to liberty, carrying the torch. Katherine, Big Narstie, you thought it was...
Julius Caesar. Move on with the quiz, please.
OK. Time for another quick bonus round. This is the part of the show where I introduce two mystery guests. All you have to do is work out who they are and why they might be noteworthy. However, you can only ask them yes and no questions. Please welcome our mystery guests. Very good to see you. I would say hello and ask you a few questions, but obviously I can't because you're mystery guests. You can only ask them yes or no questions. As soon as you think you've got it, write down the answer and we'll move on.
Are you married?
Yes.
To each other?
Yes.
Were you involved in a news story together?
Yes.
Are you swingers?
Not yet. It was only a yes.
They are not famous for being swingers.
Was the news story in the last 12 months?
No.
Oh, in the last 5 years?
No.
Did it relate to your marriage?
Yes.
Was it in 10 years ago?
No.
9?
No.
8? 7?
No.
Is it more than?
20 years ago?
More than.
What?
Have you been married since you were 2?
Thank you.
Are you more closely related than married couples ought to be?
Great question.
Thank you.
No.
Okay.
Was it 30 years ago? When was it? Was it 30 years ago?
It can only
was
say
it no. More than 30 years ago? Was no, it when you were born? 30.
Oh, what fucking year was it? She's going to ask forever. Okay, I'm going to give you a clue here. So, they're married, that's a huge part of it. And how they got married is a big part of it. It was more of a first.
So, you were the first people to do a particular ceremony?
Yes.
You got married on TV?
Yes.
Round of applause, no. OK.
More specific than that.
Did you meet through a game show?
Yes.
OK, write down your answers. Write down your answers, that's all you're getting. OK, we've all got answers. OK, well, tell us, who are you?
We are the first couple to get married, having met on blind date.
Yeah!
Well done. Let's have a look and see whether you got the answer to that. OK, so blind date, Sandy and Joe, you got it. Katherine, Big Narstie, what did you put?
Live TV.
But I suppose we've been married on live TV. You're close, but you don't get a point for that. And David and Frank?
First blind date marriage.
OK, well done. Before we chat to you, should we have a look at you in your glory? Take a look.
I often work as a Tarzanogram in the evenings to get some extra... It's true. How would this affect our relationship?
Well, that would suit me fine, actually, because I work several nights a week as a kissogram. We might even go into business together. Anyway, you'd soon get fed up, because once you got to know me, you'd want to spend every evening in with me.
Well, I never.
It's time to choose now. Who are you going for?
Number 2.
Tell us first impressions.
Well, she's lovely. Yeah, very nice.
Very nice.
Very, very good.
And she's still in.
Oh, you're so sweet. You got married off the back of meeting on blind date. How many years have you been married now?
27.
Was Scylla at the wedding?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Was
along with
the
17 million people watched it.
But is that more than the last royal wedding? I think it was.
Yeah. I think it was.
That's
the ratings for the year.
Yeah. So let's have a look and see what that's done to the scores. We've got Katherine and Big Narstie have got 23, Sandy and Joe have got 28. In the lead, David and Frank with 35. We're going to take another short break. Ladies and gentlemen, big hand for Alex and Sue. The Big Fat Quiz of everything. The next round is all about places. There are all kinds of places in the UK you can visit and have a nice time. And if you don't fancy that, you could always go to Middlesbrough. Stonehenge is amazing. It commemorates a time thousands of years ago when several ancient druids got together and thought, we need something to go with this gift shop and car park. There's actually very little you can tell me about ancient Greece, because I'm not interested and I won't bother listening. OK, time for some more questions. Why might owning a guinea pig land you in trouble with the law in Switzerland?
Ooh.
Owning a guinea pig?
Yeah, owning a guinea pig. All right, second question here. Have a look at this photo of the Zarro Stadium in Brazil. What's unusual about the halfway line?
What's unusual about the halfway line?
It's in Brazil. What's unusual about it? OK. Take a close look at this picture of Paris. What's unusual about it?
OK. Let's do that.
OK. Now we go over to Radio 1 DJ, Clara Ampho.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, I am often surrounded by stars in the live lounge, but it's an entirely different type of astronomical body I want to ask you about, the moon. The moon has got 22 seas, but can you name three of them?
So name three seas on the moon. You can all name one, and that is it.
We can all name one sea on the moon?
Yeah, we can all name one. There's one really famous one. Finally, time for another Say What You See, a very satisfying Say What You See. It's to do with places. Which famous event in exploration history is being spelt out here? OK, let's go to some answers. I asked you why owning a guinea pig in Switzerland might land you in trouble. What did you put? Sandi, any idea?
We put they're illegal, but we couldn't think why.
Ah.
Ah.
They are not illegal.
I think it's illegal. You have to have two, otherwise it's considered cruel because they'll get lonely.
What did you put?
Because you need a pair.
That's the right answer. That's the right answer for the right reason. I'm afraid that's wrong. You can't. I mean, technically...
It's illegal to have one.
Yeah. You can't have one. You've got to have a pair. OK, next question. I showed you a picture of a football pitch in Brazil. I asked you what was weird about the halfway line. What did you put?
That halfway line is not halfway.
OK, that's not the right answer.
I guessed it was on two different hemispheres, and then Frank extrapolated from that that the line is on the equator.
Ooh!
100% right.
Ah. Wow!
Sandi and Joe, I think you've got this as well, but you've put it in a very nice way, as you do.
Zero latitude.
Yes.
Correct. All right, I showed you a picture of Paris. I asked you what was unusual about it. What did you put?
It's not in France.
Not in France.
You said...
It is in Japan.
And
we said it's a model. It's a tiny model taken from a funny angle.
It's not a model. It is a real place. In Japan is not the right answer. It's not in France. I've got to give you that. It's actually in China.
Can I say the least impressive plaque I've ever seen was on Blackpool Tower, where it says, Blackpool Tower, the 122nd tallest freestanding tower in the world.
Clara Ampho asked you to name three seas on the moon. What have you got?
We could only think of the really famous one, Mare Tranquillitatis.
The Sea of Tranquility, Vitamin C and CBeebies.
Yeah.
Those are the most famous seas.
No.
OK, Katherine, what did you put?
Clowns Rice River. Big Narstie knew that one. Taurus, Goa, Belmo and Xavier.
As guesses go, they're great guesses. David, Frank?
Well, we knew Tranquility and I had an idea that was a kind of a theme, that they all sounded a bit like that. So we went for Serenity and Sincerity.
Well, two of those are right.
Wow!
Not Sincerity. There's no Sea of Sincerity.
Is it actually like water on the moon?
It's a good question. I don't know the answer. Are there actually... No, there's no water, is there?
No. What do you mean, a good question? There's no water on the moon.
Well, that's where we got tripped up. Yes.
I mean, it's a...
This is a fucking mindfuck, man.
You could have had the Sea of Tranquility, Sea of Clouds, Sea of Moisture, the Sea of Showers and the Sea of Cleverness.
The fucking sea of no fucking water, you mean?
And of course, the fucking sea of no fucking water. And finally, we had a Say What You See. Did you all get this?
Yep. Yes.
It was, of course...
Captain Scott's Arctic Expedition.
Oh, no!
Antarctic.
Yeah, Captain Scott's Antarctic Expedition.
Oh, you got it, though.
Yeah, we almost got it. We had
Mega Can Scott's Arctic
But we
What
didn't
was that? Know. What was your first word?
Mega.
Mega Can, because that is a Make America Great Again cap.
Mega Can.
Mega Can.
How did you get Mega Can?
I thought it was like...
Captain.
Do you know what's crazy about us? Is that...
That's your answers.
No, that, like, we were able to get...
going on if we can figure out Antarctic expedition? And then we...
Did you think Megacan was the first person to go to the North Pole?
It sounds like Madagascar.
Points to Sandi and Joe, points to David and Frank.
Now, I'm going to point something out because I think someone will notice it on the telly, which is we got it wrong. We've said Captain Scott's Arctic expedition, not Antarctic.
Hang on.
Yes, and it makes a big difference because you said North Pole and it's South Pole.
It's the wrong pole.
Yeah.
OK, well, just points to Sandi and Joe there. You said exploration, not expedition, but we are going to give you the point.
Hang on. We're not going to get any points just because we missed out one syllable.
We were in the right fucking part of the world.
Hang on. There's been a steward's inquiry. Points for Sandi and Joe, points for David and Frank, no points for Captain.
No, but we also had Antarctic Expedition and Scott, which was the captain's name.
Yeah, Magacan. Time now for another bonus question. It's time to welcome a special guest. It's First State's barman, Merlin Griffith. Hey, Merlin.
Hey, how are you, Jimmy?
Very good to see you.
Thank you for having me.
I believe you have a question for these good people.
I do. Our question today, excuse me, I will need some glasses.
Yeah, just in case you thought he wasn't sexy enough, he puts on the glasses a bit. Bit of swagger. Superman. Go on, Merlin.
So, I'm going to make three classic cocktails, talking you through the ingredients as I make each one. All I need you to do is write down the names of the cocktails I've made.
OK, make some drinks.
No, I will. So, the first drink, we've got a little vodka, a little... What is that? White rum. We have tequila and gin. And a little triple sec.
Right.
A little lemon juice.
Yeah, because you don't want it to be too alcoholic.
No.
I'll take all the edge off that lemon juice. OK, so rum, gin, tequila, vodka, triple sec, lemon juice...
And cola.
Yes.
And that gives us our first cocktail.
OK. I mean, that is... So write down what you think that might be. Write down that one.
Right, OK, there's your first one.
We can do all three. OK, so that's the first one.
Hey, go. Oh,
lovely. Do you want to try it? So Joe, good. Any interest?
Yeah, always.
All right, perfect.
Exactly.
Enjoy.
It's that good time of night.
Yeah, that should be delicious.
The
next one.
Lovely. The next one's going to have rum, some lime, a little mint, touch of sugar.
Rum, lime, mint, sugar.
Little soda water.
Soda water.
We're in a nightclub, baby. Hey, what's your name, good looking?
What's up with that? I'll dish this out.
Thank you very much.
Catherine, care for one of these?
Yes, please.
Take the edge off your day. You're going to be nasty.
Lastly.
Okay, lastly.
We have whiskey, lot of.
Oh, yeah.
Lemon juice.
Whiskey, lemon juice.
Again, touch of sugar.
A little bit of sugar.
An egg white.
Fucking hell.
And a little bitters.
So Angostura bitters.
And there you have it.
I mean, this is beautifully done.
Close your eyes and you're at a Magaluf sex party.
I'll taste that. That looks all right. Egg white. This is. And how did you get salmonella? Fun story.
So the plan is whiskey, egg white.
Oh, lemon, sugar, bitters.
That a good one?
Tell you what, yeah.
Is that nice?
Do you want to try it? It's
yes,
pretty,
please.
Pretty bloody great.
Get them all over here.
Ooh. That's delicious.
Ooh, I just got an electric shock off you.
That's
you sexual... are a robot.
Okay, well, let's see if they got them right. Okay, so the first one was, what was the ingredients again?
Vodka, gin, tequila, triple sec, rum, lemon, and absolutely right there. One, two, three, Long Island iced tea.
Long Island iced tea, okay.
Next one was rum, lime, mint, sugar, soda.
And that was?
A mojito. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We've got...
Yes, yes.
Yes.
And...
We put sex on the beach because we thought there'd be something like that. Like slow, comfortable screw. Which is a stupid name anyway, because really you could call it like a fast, awkward mess.
OK, and the last one was?
And our last one was a whiskey sour, which was our bourbon and our lemon juice and our egg white. Sugar and a touch of bitters.
OK, so Sandi and Joe got that, David and Frank got that, and Catherine and Big Narstie didn't.
We had no idea.
What do you think it was?
We just made up a name, because Big Narstie's heard of it before. He said it was fancy, so we called it a fancy slice. However...
Fancy slice?
Yeah, we didn't know what it was.
Let's take a look and see what that's done to the scores. OK, we've got... well, in last place, by some margin, Katherine and Big Narstie have 26 points. Sandi and Joe have 35. Frank and David, 41 points, way out in the lead. We're going to take a short break to enjoy our cocktails. Well, one more time, big hand for Merlin Griffiths. Thank you. Quiz of everything. Our next round is potluck. Yes, it's time to shove our junk through the glory hole of chance and see what gives it a suck. We use a lot of German words in English, although if they'd had their way in the 1940s, we'd be using all of them. OK, time for our last set of questions. Scuba, laser and taser are all acronyms. What do they stand for?
Oh, no.
So you've got to squeeze them all in. Scuba, laser and taser.
Sandi and I don't want to play anymore because we've got out an indoor croquet set.
For our next question, it's over to boy band Heartthrobs, Boyzone.
How are you, Jimmy?
Hey, Jimmy.
It's great to be back on the road with our 25th anniversary tour.
We got together way back in 1993, but can your teams remember which worldwide 90s craze launched the very same year? Bringing us...
Legs the Frog, Squealer the Pig, Digger the Crab,
Chili the Polar Bear, and Splash the Whale.
Life is a roller coaster. Just start to ride it.
Snap, Crackle and Pop first appeared in adverts for Rice Krispies in 1933, but in the 1950s, a fourth member was very briefly added to the group. Can you name him?
Pre-cum.
The nursery rhyme, "There was an old lady who swallowed a fly," details the tragic fallout from a woman accidentally swallowing a fly. But what finished her off? Couldn't be simpler. What household product had a number of original uses, including foot cleaning, floor scrubbing, and treating gonorrhea? Oh, Frank knows. All right, let's get some answers. The acronym SCUBA LASER TASER, what do they stand for?
Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus.
Correct.
Light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation.
Correct.
And pink, I couldn't quite remember, Thomas A. Swift electric rifle.
Perfect. 3 for 3. I'd like to ask the semi-literate David Baddiel and Frank Skinner what they scribbled.
Well, we wrote single canister underwater breathing apparatus. Then we had a breakdown and I just wrote light ant.
No. Katherine, Big Narstie, what have you got?
Sussex and Cambridge uni bitches.
That's the one.
It's not that. That was their second choice in the ideas meeting. What about laser?
Yeah.
Light arrow stun energy reaction and then...
Tactical arrow stun energy reach.
No, that is incorrect. So you get all the points there, Sandi and Joe. Well done. Yes. OK. Now, Boyzone asked you about a craze that started in 1993. It was huge. What did you put, David?
We didn't put anything for this.
OK. What did you put, Sandi, Joe?
We thought it was dance, some kind of dancing.
A dance craze. Something really crazy that the kids were all doing.
Splash the Whale sounds a bit like a blokey euphemism for having a piss, but it wasn't that, I presume. Yeah.
Sadly, no. What did you get?
Well, first we put Brian McFadden, respect. He was not asked to rejoin the band.
I think he was in Westlife,
wasn't
he? Okay. So I could see why Boyzone wouldn't ask him to join their band, because he was in a different band.
Yeah, that's a fair point.
Mrs. MAGA Can.
Okay. All right, and then we thought it was... Is it Pogs?
I can tell you the answer is Legs the Frog, Squealer the Pig, Digger the Crab, Chili the Polar Bear, Splash the Whale, all Beanie Babies.
Fuck. I should have known that.
You're genuinely upset at your performance this evening.
I was trying really hard.
I asked you to name the fourth character added to Snap, Crackle and Pop.
We put Puff because we thought it sounded good.
What did you write?
I got tingle, I got tingle.
Tingle. Snap, crackle, pop, tingle.
No, tingle, snap, crackle, then pop.
Oh. It's, I mean, it's wrong, but it's wrong earlier.
OK.
OK, and what did you...
We had a long discussion about this, and I was... Cos I'm a bit tired, I wrote snap, as if it was snap, crackle, pop and snap again, which obviously is wrong.
Double snap.
Wasn't happy with that.
Yeah, then...
But we thought pop as well.
Take a look at this.
You know snap, crackle and pop.
And pow!
Well, they've got a bug by the name of
pow!
Pow means power and power's nice.
Rice Krispies power from whole grain rice.
I said pow. I said pow, but I crossed it out.
Sure, you said pow, but crossed it out.
You could see it. You could see it. I said pow.
Yeah, it makes sense. He was the only one alive at that age, flipping off.
I asked you what finished off the old lady that swallowed a fly.
I swallowed a horse.
Of course.
What?
Are you not familiar with the story? It's a huge story at the time. There was no lady that swallowed a fly.
I'm fucking black. You keep telling me this crazy stuff about horses and flies. Why are you telling me something about Bob Marley?
Big Narstie, I take your point, but there was no woman who swallowed a fly, right? And then, because she swallowed a fly, she then swallowed a spider to get the fly.
Then she swallowed a bird.
Yeah, then she swallowed to get the spider, because obviously that was a problem. Yeah. And then she swallowed a cat to get the bird.
It was going well, because then she got a dog to go after the cat. I think the mistake was the next one, because she got a cow to go after the dog.
Which, I mean, famously, that's cows ridiculous. Don't really eat dogs.
Ridiculous.
But then to get the cow out, she had what?
What are you going to choose?
Right? So no one phoned RSPCA? What's going on?
Well, she didn't. Well, they should have, because she swallowed a horse.
Yeah.
She died, of course.
Of
She's
course.
A badass. She's a badass.
OK. Did you... David and Frank, you got this. Everyone got this. Points all round. OK. Finally, I asked you what product could be used to clean your feet or your floor or treat gonorrhea. OK, now, Katherine, you were very confident you got this. What was it?
Vinegar. And then Robitussin as well, Big Narstie said.
OK, well, both wrong.
Yeah. Oh.
David, Frank, you put vinegar?
We put vinegar as well. Is vinegar wrong?
It is wrong. The answer is, Sandi?
Listerine.
Listerine, yes.
What? Mouthwash?
Well, the mouthwash came later.
So you put mouthwash in your cock?
You can put mouthwash on your dingle down.
Well, burn, isn't it? That'll fucking burn.
Makes you wonder how they discovered it worked as a mouthwash. When it had been a gonorrhea treatment.
I imagine whoever owned the company was having a hell of a weekend. Got one more question. It's time for our final big fat question. I'm incredibly excited. We're joined by Hollywood royalty. Some of the biggest stars in the world are here tonight. Please welcome our very special guests. I mean, if you squint a bit and you're...
Yes, really good, really good.
OK, so here's my question. So these are all huge Hollywood blockbuster stars. Yep. We've got Tom Hanks. I believe anyone in that outfit looks as much like Tom Hanks as you. Will Smith, the glasses doing a lot of the heavy lifting there. Robert Downey Jr., Emma Watson, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, The Pebble, more The Pebble than The Rock, and Julia Roberts. So, between them, these stars have all grossed billions at the worldwide box office. All you've got to do is put them in order from the most bankable to the least bankable. So, ooh, we're only counting films where they played the lead or joint lead. Who brought in the most cash at the box office? 2 points for each correct answer and 10 points if you get the order right. Oh, a lot of murmuring. It's a good question.
Can I do my quote from Harry Potter?
Yes.
Yeah, sure.
Scared Potter.
He's the man.
Very good. Any other terrible impressions?
Here comes the man in black! Galaxy Defenders!
Can you do the dance? Can you do just bounce with me, just bounce with me, just bounce with me, come on.
Yeah!
Take a walk with me,
just
yeah! Yes. OK, so let's put them in order. So what have you got, David, Frank?
We've got Hank Smith, Rock, Downey Jr., Roberts, Watson.
OK. Katherine, Big Narstie, what have you got?
We think Harry Potter films have grossed loads. And so, we've got Emma Watson, Will Smith, Tom Hanks, Robert Downey Jr., The Rock, Julie Roberts.
OK. And then, Sandi, Joe, what have you got?
We think Robert Downey might be the highest grossing. Then Will Smith, Tom Hanks, Julie Roberts, The Rock and Hermione.
Scared, Potter.
I like that a lot. OK, well, put yourselves in order. So, closest to me with the highest grossing.
Wow.
Closest to me, highest grossing.
Robert.
Two.
So, so in reverse order, so we have Julia Roberts, $5.2 billion, Will Smith, $6.8 billion, The Rock, $7.6 billion, Emma Watson, $9 billion, Tom Hanks, $9.5 billion, Robert Downey Jr., $11.3 billion at the box office. OK, so, one point there. You managed to not get any of those right.
Just think what a great round that would have been if you had the real people. Yeah. to make them stand in order of... brilliant.
Can
what about if we do it?
Because Jimmy will win.
Let's have a look and see what that's done to the scores. I can tell you that in last place, deservedly so, we have... Big Narstie and Katherine Ryan with 29 points. And we have joint winners. Sandi Toksvig and Joe Lycett have 42. Frank Skinner, David Dill have 42. Your joint winners are the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. There's no tiebreaker. OK. I'm going to put this... you can fight for it. Well, jump up. You've all won a prize. Your joint winners are the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Well, that's it. A big thank you to our panel, our special guests, and thank you for watching. I'm Jimmy Carr. This has been the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Good night.